Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel Charts Chapter 5, The Paired Bar Chart. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. In the charting book, Chapter 5, talks about doing comparisons, and this paired bar chart is pretty cool, although it requires a bit of trickery in order to get it to work. So it works when you're comparing two different populations. For example, here, preference for ice cream flavors, kids and adults. And so what we're going to do is we're going to first sort it by one of the factors. In this case, adults. We'll put it in adult sequence. And then I need to take the numbers on the left and make them negative. So here's how I'm going to do that. I'm going to take a minus one, copy the minus one, and then I'm going to use paste special multiply. Paste special multiply. So edit, paste special. I'm going to choose multiply. Click OK. Or now, paste special is a little bit harder now. You can always find it down here at the bottom of the paste dropdown, choosing paste special. And so that gets one set of numbers to be negative, but I don't want them to show up as negative. This is where the trickery comes in. So I'm going to go to the number category here in Home and hit the dialog launcher. You can also do Control 1. And I'm going to set up a custom format of 0, semicolon, 0. When you have two different zones here separated by a semicolon, the first one's for positive, the second one's for negative, and most people, of course, would do minus 0 to get that second number to show up as negative, but I want it to show up as positive. So this just affects how it displays. So it's actually storing minus 162, but showing me 162. All right, so we've made that negative. Now let's create our bar chart here. This is going to be a stacked bar chart. So insert charts, bar, and we want the stacked bar. All right, we'll change the zoom a little bit here. A couple of things. The most popular flavor appears at the bottom. Legend appears along the right. So I want to change the legend. We'll go to legend, show legend at top. The beautiful thing there now is the legend now matches kids on the left, adults on the right. I want to get the largest, most popular flavor at the top. Okay, so that's going to be the vertical category axis, format selection, and we're going to choose something called categories in reverse order. So now we have the largest items at the top. The chart currently is a little bit not quite symmetrical, going from 200 to 150. So we'll choose that, double click, and say that the minimum is going to be fixed at minus 200. The maximum is also going to be fixed at 200. That ensures that we're a little bit symmetrical. And then you have to make a call here. These labels that are appearing near the center axis, is that intruding on the chart or not? One thing that you could do is double click the horizontal axis again, and there's something called axis labels. Right now it's next to axis. If I say low, click close that. Funny, it should have worked, didn't work. Axis labels, low, click close, there we go. All right, don't know why that didn't work the first time. Moves those over to the left. So now we get to see, in descending order, adults prefer vanilla, butter pecan, chocolate chip. Kids, yep, on the vanilla, definitely on the chocolate, but much more preference for strawberry and blue moon than butter pecan. So interesting, creating a paired bar chart. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.